Hello, but I hope you're doing well. My name is Jake. Welcome back to another episode of Jake's News. Hope you guys all enjoy today's great stories. The first of which, though, is a big one out there, the comparison of the player base of PUBG, of course, the popular uprising game on the scene right now, and that of CSGO. So I'm going to show you guys a clip actually brought to us last week by Brendan Green. If you guys did not see this, the former founder and, of course, the creator of PlayerUnknown Battlegrounds has actually come out and said some very interesting things about including the Chinese player base in their player counts, and that's a big reason why people think there's a large gap between PUBG and CSGO player bases. Here's what he had to say about the topic and very interesting words.
China, like our numbers on Steam are mainly because of China. Like our peak is because
really?
Of China. It's because like,
really?
So.
Could you guess what percentage are Chinese? Just a ballpark?
Oh no, you can see it on
oh,
Steam
can.
Spy. So you can see it. It's like 60-odd% of the
Holy
players.
Smokes.
Oh no, it's a massive percentage. Like, I mean,
wow.
I didn't realize how big China was. So
oh,
like
man.
Dota and CSGO, they run their own builds in China, right? Mm. They have Perfect World distributing. So you don't get to see the Chinese CCU, which is probably like a million or not or more of people playing in China. Mm. With our game, you get to see the Chinese market. So you get to see that, you know, million or you know, 2 million CCU because of China. Like, China is a huge market.
And this comes in big news, because over the course of the past few months, while PUBG is having enormous player-based numbers, of course, people saying PUBG is taking over, CSGO is dying. If you look at the charts, that still could definitely be true. PUBG having that, of course, that explosive growth there, and that kind of exponential growth is rare to see in many games, and of course, they still have those player peak numbers that far exceed that of CSGO's. And if you guys look at CSGO's charts as well, we're not too surprised to see the fact that, yes, the player base has been decreasing. Now, again, this could be due to dormant winter months. Of course, throughout the winter season, especially throughout December and January, we're going to see fewer players and hopefully spike back up around major time in January. But it's definitely not good to look at those graphs. And even if you do add in a million or so Chinese players right now run by Perfect World, it could be more, it could be less than a million players over there in China. It's still a large gap between PUBG and what they're doing. Of course, that exponential growth this way and what CSGO is doing, invert that and we're going downhill fast. So I really am kind of curious to see what you guys think about this. Is CSGO dying? I myself personally don't think so. I think that graph is a little bit too exaggerated there. I think it's definitely a stagnant growth. I think we're still retaining our player base numbers out there, especially around major times. But when it comes to what PUBG is doing and CSGO is doing, whether we have the Chinese player base included in our numbers or not, CSGO is definitely doing something wrong when compared to PUBG. I still think it's a great game. Of course, I still love it, but there's definitely something to look at there for the data and the future of the game itself. And speaking of our next major, where I do expect to receive some hopefully more players joining the CSGO scene, we do have some leaked images of our Series 3 pins coming sometime soon. These have not officially been released as of right now, guys, but here are the leaked images of those Series 3 pins. I myself have a Series 2 pin. It's actually a cobblestone pin sent to me by my good friend Joel, and it's actually a pretty cool pin if you guys collect these kind of things. But unfortunately, to get some of these genuine pins on screen, you'll actually have to attend the E-League Major itself in Boston if you want to get your hands on one of these. Otherwise, people do try and sell them online as well. I might try and get my hands on one of the HAL ones, though, because that is an absolutely sick pin. So for all of you guys who do collect these Series pins, they are pretty cool this year, and this time around. So great job, Valve. They look amazing. And if you guys actually unbox some or actually bring some home, feel free to tweet me pictures of those of the pins you guys receive. And I would love to share that story on CSGO News or Jake's News next episode. So hope you guys all enjoyed that. And on top of that, though, speaking of players leaving the CSGO player base, we do have a 15-year-old Finnish pro. He actually came onto the scene just last year joining Havu, the Finnish team over there. His name is Sergei, and apparently he is already leaving the CSGO pro player scene and leaving video games in general, taking a break from them. According to HLTV, he actually had an article with them just last week talking about his up-and-coming pro career, and a week later, actually I think it was 3 days later, he comes out and says he is leaving Team Havu and he's taking a break from video games altogether. Now, we of course had Lerpus make a joke, maybe he's leaving CSGO for World of Warcraft. Maybe World of Warcraft can retain their player base longer than CSGO can. I mean, they certainly have a great history of that. I think it's all jokes aside, though, it's very sad to see this pro player at the age of 15 taking a break from a video game. It goes to show you probably how many immense hours he was spending just to play CSGO and try and go pro. The fact that he's already sick of the game and lacking motivation, and of course due to other personal reasons, he is taking a break. It's a very sad story to see because he was a very good up-and-coming pro. Of course, many pro players out there don't start their professional careers at that kind of level at 14 or 15 years of age, so he had a great potential, and it's very sad to see, guys. But as of right now, Sergei from Team Havu has left that roster, and they will miss him dearly. And we also had Virtus.pro's very own Snacks come out with his big tattoo. That thing might still be a little bit raw come around major time, so please watch out for snacks, guys. A big brand new tattoo for the guy. And also on top of that, for our last story for today's episode of CSGO News, we do have Freakazoid, who's actually quit streaming for quite some time now, taking a break. If you guys remember, though, he joined his little brother Cooper on the team Muffin Lightning, and actually has joined them ever since October, and apparently been quite distracted playing with those guys. Who knows what their next plans are? I know a lot of people talk about the big downgrade Freakazoid has taken from his previous teams. Of course, Echo Fox being the latest, and of course now being on Team Muffin Lightning, who has not showed up to anything really substantial as of right now. And of course, him taking that long break from streaming has caused a few people to, you know, wonder where he was. So Jason R did answer that question on his stream, and apparently not only does Freakazoid just not like streaming, he's also been very distracted time-wise playing with this new team. So expect some big things for Freakazoid in the future, and we'll see if he sticks around with that Muffin Lightning roster, or if he tries to join a bigger North American roster, which people certainly expected back in the day, but who knows where he'll be going now.
Oh yeah, and Ryan, I remember asking Ryan why he doesn't stream anymore, and it was because he said, what did he say? He said he doesn't like to stream. He says he can't, like, it's hard, like, he doesn't like to talk to chat and play at the same time. He just doesn't like to do that shit. And he's still, and he's trying to be, he's, like, he's joining his, he joined a team with his brother and shit. You know what I'm saying? So.
And that's going to do it for today's episode of Jake's News. I think it just sounds so, it sounds so selfish saying thanks for watching an episode of Jake's News. I don't know what to do with the channel name, guys. I really don't. Leave a comment down below. What should I change the channel name to? I really am stuck in this point in time. So hope you guys all enjoyed watching this episode of News. And if you guys did enjoy, please leave a like or a comment down below. I'll see you in a couple days, guys. Hope you all enjoyed. Remember, I like you. My name is Jake. And goodbye.